And even, especially,
if they would gloat to her, she would let them talk. And then she would finish with, "That's nice, but are you a good person?" That's all she cared about.
Are you in there?
Yeah, sorry. Is it cutting my head off?
I can't tell with all that shit on it.
Wrong way, huh?
I like the flag in the background.
Welcome.
You good?
I think so.
Alright, here we go.
Here we go.
Error.
Okay. Test fire.
Reload.
Test fire. I shared a, I sent this photo to the guys at, Sawfleet. I said, "Got those new board shorts. They don't show too much leg, do they?" And their response was hilarious. I was at work when they sent it. Let me show you. And I just responded, "Ha ha ha."
Too late, bro.
Rounds down range.
Rounds down range. Too late.
It was pretty funny.
Check, check, check. Too late, bro. Why is
Can we share this?
I guess I just have much more of a baritone voice than your...
Let's go.
Than your little, quiet little mouse voice.
How's that? Deep, deep.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to Conviction Strong Podcast. That's not right, man. I don't like it.
What's wrong? Conviction Strong Radio.
Yeah. Yeah.
How do you get anything done without a mouse? That's my question. I'm a mouse guy. There's something I gotta do. I gotta put my thing on PayPal. And I refuse to do it on my phone because I don't have a mouse. I don't care.
Why am I so jacked on this thing?
What is the matter?
It's just spiking more than normal.
Oh. His name was Craig.
Yeah. Hey everybody, welcome to Conviction Strong Radio. I'm Craig Heisel. With me, as always, is my favorite wingman, the grooviest, loveliest man in the world, Jake Walsh. Jake, say hi to everybody back at the ranches or cars or wherever they're listening at home.
What? Back at the ranch?
Yeah.
Hello, all.
There could be people listening from ranches, I think. Cowboys, yeah, and such.
Yeah, he just hit me with that one. I wasn't prepared. We're also recording with the video.
Oh yeah, we're doing a little
media.
We're doing a video test. We're gonna see how it goes and
yeah, test fire in that.
A YouTube channel for Conviction Strong Radio if things go well.
Yeah. Keep your mouse, your hand on the mouse.
We figured if Jake and I figured if we were gonna start our own production company, we'd name it Bush League Productions.
Keith Stone. That was the one.
Who's that?
Keith Stone. Keith Stone made a it was an advertising thing.
Oh, I remember that.
He was just smooth. But not as smooth as Keystone.
Right.
Those were funny.
Now that we're on video, I gotta watch what we're doing with our hands.
It was like Joe Dirt of Keystone beer.
Let's get into the show.
Joe Dirte. Don't church it up, Dirt Boy.
Life's a garden, gotta dig it. So, Jake and I have been getting questions. More and more questions from everybody, so it's really cool. I think we're going to be working toward an actual Q&A show.
Oh, I thought you were going to say working towards a third listener.
Right.
Yeah, the Q&A also.
It feels like
yeah.
We've garnered more than one listener now. For some reason, people seem more and more interested in what we have to say. So that's very, very cool. Thank you for listening. But we're going to start with we're going to answer a question today. I think Jake and I feel it's pretty relevant, and it's from somebody that I have a personal relationship with and care about very much. So we're gonna get after it today. I'm going to read you all the question, and then I'm not going to say the person's name, and then Jake and I are going to try to answer it.
Okay.
So the question says, Craig, I would like you and Jake to address a problem I have suffered with the entire time I've done CrossFit. I am incredibly proud of how far I've come. I'm proud that I didn't quit, but... And a but negates everything that has gone before, but I'm also embarrassed by how far I have yet to go. I post a picture on Facebook and my old lady friends think it is awesome. But I know it is a low weight, and I often scale the movement, or the rep count with the coach's input. I try to remain positive in the face of my hampering issues. I'm old and feeble and have a heart rate problem, but I don't give up. There are videos of incredible feats of strength and amazing achievements, and I do so little in comparison to those young, fit, full-time athletes. I know all this, but how does one stay positive with the limitations imposed by life itself? I'm not getting any younger, but I have gotten considerably stronger, and my flexibility has improved, and even my crappy heart rate isn't as crampy. But I'm still not going to be doing a rope climb or string together a bunch of double unders or even manage a real handstand push-up. I don't RX the workout. Well, okay, I have 3 times in 4 years, and twice it was row until you reach England or something like that. And so I always know I am like the dumb kid in class, surrounded by geniuses and struggling to just get by. So, how do I tell myself and believe myself that I'm doing enough, am awesome in my struggle, and have been brave enough to keep going against all odds and any good sense I may have once possessed? So some interesting questions and some interesting descriptive words in here.
That, you know, it's two things come to mind when you read that. One, everything is relative to the individual. And two, perspective. Those are the two most overwhelming themes or thoughts that I have when you read that. And definitely, it's one of those things. I don't always have it's laborious for me to have a positive perspective about my own circumstances. I can handle someone else's situation a little bit better, I feel. And I can be positive on their behalf, maybe because I'm detached, in a sense. Or it's easier to detach because it's not me going through it. But for me personally, my perspective is always, as you would say, vacillating. It goes dark, sometimes way too dark. I get fixated on the wrong things, and I wrap myself around them. And then other times, you know, it's that old cliche, the highs are high and the lows are low. But there's definitely both often.
Yeah.
Which is a good thing, because before I used to, not to make this about me, before I used to just numb, do everything I could to numb. But now there's a lot more feeling, which is new to me. So it's taken a lot to get my bearings with that, and then try to learn how to manage those feelings, because a lot of them I haven't felt in years, both good and bad. But then recognizing them, managing those feelings or perspectives, and then trying to bring back, you know, correct in order to stay positive or in order to get back to positive is physically and mentally exhausting sometimes.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's in the same day more than once, you know. And I hate saying that it's out of my control, but sometimes it is.
Well, sometimes it can certainly feel like it's out of your control.
Yeah, that's a better way of saying it.
Right. Yeah, and I think anybody that doesn't go back and forth between in the struggle for getting better, wondering, if I'm getting better or how I'm getting better, especially if you've been in the fitness game for quite some time, no matter what methodology you follow, making gains in it like you do in the beginning, it becomes more challenging.
Real quick, I think it applies to any realm or domain, not just physical fitness.
Agreed.
So like, what started this conversation was physical fitness, but I think you can take almost anything we're saying today and apply it to any domain.
I agree 100%. What a person has to ask himself is, are you in it? What are you in it for? I don't believe there's ever any real wrong or egregious answer. And are you in it for mastery? And what does mastery mean to you? So, like this individual says in the question, you know, I'm still not going to be doing a rope climb or stringing together a bunch of double unders or even manage a real handstand push-up. Is that really so, or is that the story that you tell yourself? And that's going to take some assessment. Are you putting all of your energy into getting one of those things, like stringing together double unders, or like, is your diet there? Is your sleep there? Is your practice there? Are you practicing for those things? We take people all the time that say, I never would be able to do X, and then, you know, we had two people in their 60s, a man and a woman, last year get their first pull-up of their life.
Yeah.
So, and they're not anomalies. They just had a plan and worked toward it. And
well, it takes that effort, dogged pursuit.
But to compare yourself when you're quote-unquote old and feeble to the young, fit, you know, games worthy athletes when you're doing prescribable, then you're just, I feel like you're not comparing obviously apples to apples, but two, why would you compare yourself to young,
right,
fit?
Because you're never going to go back. It's never going to be an even playing field if you're looking at it like that.
Let's look at other quote-unquote old and feeble people and see how you rank with old and feeble people, if that's how you're qualifying yourself.
I would say start there, but...
But the label, old and feeble, is toxic as well, in my opinion. And you...
Arguably, comparing yourself to any other person is toxic.
Correct.
Especially if you're prone to this kind of thinking, or depression, or fixating, or...
Right.
The negative perspectives.
The marker, for me, is...
I mean, you might look physically similar to someone, but your genetic makeup, your DNA, your soul, your nature and nurture from your birth until now are totally different.
Right.
All of the circumstances that fed you both into the same room at that same time are two totally different worlds.
Right.
So for you to compare yourself, me and you are similar in height. We both have brown hair. Like, so we should be...
I would say yours is a little bit more gray than mine.
Okay.
You know?
Yeah,
we're gonna really...
I'm wearing a hat for a reason. But, I mean, even for us to compare depth of squat is...
Your mobility is so much better than mine. You're so much stronger than... To me, comparing myself to you, I would rob myself of my work every day. And this person even says in the question, you know, I'm not getting any younger, but I have gotten considerably stronger, and my flexibility has improved, and even my crappy heart rate isn't as crappy. These are all phenomenally important things
that
from
you
a,
could fixate on.
From a well-being standpoint.
Right.
Point, you know, so...
The mental is the hardest. I will give them that. The mental is definitely the hardest part about continuing to make forward progress in any domain.
Agreed, 100% agreed. I think what we have to find as individuals is, what is the driving factor for us? Is it to do a rope climb? Is it to do a handstand push-up?
Well, let me
is
just...
Is it to do a double... Are those things important, or is...
No.
Longevity...
trick question.
They're not important to you, but I can tell you that somebody going after that goals and getting a rope climb might be very, very important for them.
I meant that they're not important in the sense that they're completely arbitrary in the bigger picture. And you can argue that about almost anything. You know, again, this goes back to everything being relative.
Tim Ferriss tells that story about when he was at Princeton and he was losing his shit about writing his thesis, and it brought him to the end, to the edge, and it got dark for him, and from someone from the outside, and he even says this, you can look at it like, oh, a fucking Princeton kid is having a hard time writing his thesis, or he got a B. Like, I wish my life was that easy.
Right.
But, again, it's all...
relative.
Right. And whether it's in the fitness realm, like... excuse me. Maybe you're putting too much weight on these things that you can't do. Why are they so important? Just because someone else can do it?
Or why are we always looking at what we can't do instead of looking at what we are doing?
Right.
And not rewarding.
And slightly modifying or making a game out of what you can do.
So let's talk about that. So there's...
I got a cough again.
There is... the term RX or prescribed is, to me, completely bullshit. We've talked about it on the podcast before.
It's a Narnian... unit of measurement. I mean, it's completely bullshit.
Right, for elite fitness and at a CrossFit level, they used to not even list
elite
weights.
Is relative.
Right. So again, we're looking at broad based measurements in a certain methodology in a certain corner of the world, you know, where it just doesn't it makes sense to the people doing it perhaps, and to others anywhere else in the world, they're like, it's like having a rugby fan watch an American football game.
They're strong, man.
Right.
There's
they don't get it.
Powerlifting. There's right. Olympic lifting. There's CrossFit. There's
so if you're doing CrossFit, a great program has a prescriptive approach to each member. So your prescription is different. And what can help you perhaps see if you are getting better if you need metrics is to set benchmark workouts, much like CrossFit does, and do them in a modified option that fits your capacity but also challenges you.
Right.
And then try that.
And compare
to
previous.
You. Right.
And not necessarily, like, I'm not a huge fan of, like, just following the one rep maxes. Sometimes I'll have you make a workout up, or I'll make one up, and then you know, it goes in the notebook like all the others, but then year later, 2 years later, I'll do it again.
Mm-hmm.
And if you do the same workout, but better or more efficient, or you felt better, if you're noting how you felt afterwards or during, you're making improvement.
Mm-hmm.
So, again, your perspective.
Mm-hmm.
You got to pick the... You got to sift through
mm-hmm.
and emphasize the important things.
Right.
To reinforce that perspective.
And if you want some kind of...
the important things to you, not...
right.
A whiteboard, not the person you're next to, not...
right.
One gym, not... any one thing that you shouldn't be, in reality, tying your value to.
Right. You know, so a lot of people come to see us to want to work on a specific skill, and we'll... they'll meet with us for a half hour, we'll evaluate the skill, then we'll give them homework and check back with them every 2 weeks, modifying the homework as necessary with each meeting until they acquire the skill that they're after.
Can I have one of those napkins?
Yeah, so one of the things that, you know, people that feel the way this person does who wrote in is could pick one skill, get trained on how to do it, get a proper homework plan, and go after that way, but then the little time you're doing in the gym can be completely erased if you're not eating right or sleeping right or whatever other habits you're doing throughout the day. So when you're looking at what you want and you're not devoted all in to getting that thing, then be prepared to not get that thing as quickly as you want or ever,
right.
And also know that there's always the risk that nothing is guaranteed and that you might not ever get it. So
right.
You have to look at piecemeal, and maybe I want to climb halfway up a rope to start, and that's I won that, and then maybe it's the next. Maybe I want to do a handstand push-up off three ab mats
and then two, and then one, and then maybe I'm good there, maybe, you know, these little physical goals that can be parceled into,
games almost, or
yeah, they pursuits. Can, it's more bite-sized, yeah. And when I, you know, there's a kid, CJ Cummings, who has, is, I think he's 16 or 17, you probably know, he's got a 400-pound clean and jerk, you know, there's no way ever in hell that I will ever get that, and that has no bearing.
Not with that attitude.
On my worth. Well, I won't get it because I tell you because I don't want it, Bennett. Like, I don't care, you know?
But it's cool to see that stuff, but he's an outlier.
It's awesome to see that stuff. So then we get in the question, are we comparing ourselves to outliers, you know, as means of
right
our greatness? So it's so hard to get, I feel, to get people to understand that you control everything about the way that you view the world. And if you're disappointed, at the end of the day, you're 100% responsible for that disappointment. When I'm mad at my wife, it's my fault I'm mad at my wife. No matter what she's doing to me.
You're speaking like Jocko about extreme ownership. So basically,
of every single thing that you think, say, feel, or do, and the responsibility that that takes.
So basically, if you're upset with someone, either A, you didn't communicate with them,
right,
what you expected, right, out of that situation, right, or B, they reacted differently, and now you're fixated on that instead, right, of moving forward with the situation. Right, so, again, the control falls back on you.
Correct.
In what you're saying.
All the time. And I think the more that we can embrace that aspect, I think the happier people are. The person that wrote this question in is a phenomenal person, but their view of themselves as old and feeble is wrong.
Yeah, I agree.
You know, it's not, they're not old and feeble. Old and feeble, I've seen old and feeble. Well, they can't move. They can't tie their own shoes. They
wouldn't be able to tie.
Live on respirators. That's old and feeble. They take three steps and fall and break their hip. They don't have some kind of life at all.
Right. So
they're overweight. They're diabetic. They are on pills. That's old and feeble.
So again, not to make this situation about me. With veterans, though, you see. Guys that got out that aren't able to do what they used to do, or they're not able to do things that they had done as well as they had done them any longer. So there's a bit of an identity issue.
Yeah.
There's some things that I can't do that I used to do, sure, or they're a lot harder now,
yeah,
than they were 10 yeah years ago. So I go back and forth on being old and feeble compared to what I was 10 years ago.
Right.
The hell I was gonna say. It's about, I don't know what, I just drew a blank. It's the ability to carry forward in life after that, when there are people that don't anymore, that are gone. The ability to continue to play, to try to improve, the ability to look at a situation and use your brain to try to figure out